said kick his tail.
Are you filming?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Oh, man. He's better than I thought he was.
Yeah, right.
Hey, Sifu Jason with Greenville Academy Martial Arts, and thanks for watching. We want to cover Chi Sao stuff. The way everyone does Chi Sao is different from family to family, so I'm not saying that this is all encompassing. We're just talking about the way we use it, what it's for. Because maybe you don't know Wing Chun too well, or maybe you've been doing it for a little bit, and no one's really explained, you know, why you're doing this. Because it can look kind of weird, you know, two guys just doing this cross arm stuff. So fundamentally, what we use it for is it's a great intermediate training drill for a range that's not trained very well. Anything else, we can grapple, we can box, but once we get into the clinch, it's difficult to train at. And Chi Sao is an ingenious way to train that area and the targets that we're going to be going after. So, for example, if we're infighting, the most dangerous things in infighting really are the easy access to the eyes, the chin, you know, and the jaw, and of course the throat and the neck. Not just the windpipe, but also the neck. Taking shots anywhere in this area becomes really problematic. It's not possible to really develop an iron eyeball or, you know, a great iron windpipe. It just can't. So you taking shots here is going to be very, very deleterious to your fighting morale. And so you want to learn, one, to cut that access off to those targets, and then two, how to go after them. You know, and Chi Sao will train you to do that. So we're rolling. What we're really trying to do is cut off that line. So if you look at the way Aaron is structured here with his Fook Sao, if I try to hit him, I'm cut off by his basic positioning of his hand, his forearm, and his elbow. And so I really try to touch him. I'm gonna leave myself open for the same problem. Like I said, it's designed to cut that off and open it up. So again, no matter what we're doing, is we're rolling. We're really trying to work at cutting off access to us right up the middle and go after him in that case. So the second thing about it is that we want to make sure we know why we're doing the drill. Obviously, we want to make sure we're doing this drill for real fighting, not so we can beat each other at Chi Sao. And that is kind of a problem in Wing Chun and a lot of schools, is everyone will kind of like walk up to you.
Yeah, man.
Then they try their Chi Sao on each other. And that's like two guys in a boxing gym, and a guy walks up to the other guy. And there's these really bad 80s movies where these guys would breakdance challenge each other. And that's what like it looks like in Wing Chun. These guys try to, you know, Chi Sao challenge each other. It's like boxing. Two guys walking up, and one guy starts hitting the focus mitts or shadow box, and the other guy tries to out shadow box him. And everyone's like, yeah, that dude rocked it. And that's not fighting. You know, if you've been around boxing gyms, you know there's people who look really cool on a speed bag and jumping rope, and they can do all these switches and stuff, but they can't box that well. So Chi Sao is just a drill to give us contact reflexes so we can fight with them. We don't want to win at Chi Sao. We want to get the reflexes and get the primary objective and skills from the drill to be able to use it for fighting. And if we screw that up, we start rolling, and we're trying to touch each other. We're trying to play gotcha. And I'm putting myself in bad positions to try to catch him. And I'm like, oh, I got you! And the problem is that I'm gonna get killed, and no one's gonna remember the next day he has a fat lip, but they will remember that I'm dead. So, you know, I wanna make sure that I maintain certain things. Again, I cut off access to me, the man I love, and try to protect the person you love, right? And I wanna cut that off, and I wanna maintain facing, because in all-out fighting, there's nothing stopping him from running right at me and trying to drive me over. And if I'm in a fight in front of traffic and I'm off in this position, he just pushes me out in the traffic, I got a serious problem. I fall on a stairwell. So we're not doing this just to be good at Chi Sao so we can roll and I can go, oh, gotcha, and start to speed up and all that stuff. The idea is designed to control. And so the basic attacks are the best attacks. This one's straight up the middle, okay? Or I'm getting, and I'm trying to control this area and attack the center mass, and especially those really vulnerable targets while not opening them up for me. That would be our key.